Okay, so the next question was, what does Flutter need to become more mainstream?
Yeah, these are my personal opinions on what Flutter needs to become more mainstream. So I think one of the key main features that's lacking in Flutter is the over-the-air update, like there is in React Native and Kodowa. Oh, what is over the app it updates? It allows patch update application without having to roll update to version, updated version to Play Store and App Store. And currently, Flutter had this in the roadmap in 2019, but later postponed it because they felt like over the air update requires implementing of just-in-time compilation, and that would hinder iOS performance. They think that that's not worth taking the risk. Maybe they have to think ways of re-implementing that in the future. But for now, they postponed the plan for OTA. And the second reason is that if you allow over-the-air update, that means you allow like arbitrary execution of code when you update the applications. That in turn will open up for the people to use this loophole to install malicious script to run. And Flutter team did not want to take that risk. And the third reason why Flutter postponed is because there's no out-of-box solution, hosting solution for patching application yet at the moment. I think CodePush, they're trying to do it, but they have postponed as well. Yeah, you can read more about this, like why Flutter teams postponed this over-the-air update feature implementation more on the link.
Or boss, is it a good time for you to answer this extra question we got from the chat?
Sure.
John asked, how does OTA align with Apple App approval guidelines?
Well, actually it's not aligned, but they're sort of flexible about it. Like React Native does it, Apple's patching the JavaScript, but so far Apple has been quite lenient on it. There's a workaround on it, so they're quite lenient. If Flutter weren't implemented, then there would be like a lot of compromise, and they have to make sure that they comply with the iOS App Store policies as well.
There's the next slide for you, boss.
Yeah. Also, there's not many features and tool sets around GraphQL, like SOCO. We had this project where we use GraphQL and we require client-side management, and we were considering like two options for cross-platform, which is Flutter and React Native. But we found that Flutter doesn't, like Flutter GraphQL, which is like a community package, they don't support client-side state management or catch invalidation. And we have to sort of, instead of using Flutter as a solution, we have to use React Native instead. But if Flutter GraphQL could catch up the features and tool sets of upload client, like in React, I think that would also help people or companies to adopt Flutter more. Yeah, and one of the things I think that would make people start using Flutter is by making Flutter web more stable. Because if you look at the chart, you see that most of the software developers are JavaScript engineer, and they work on the web front end. And if the Flutter team can make this to happen, I think we can encourage web developers to try out Flutter more, and therefore they learn about Dart and pick up the framework.
I'll cover Flutter for web a bit more later, and also the desktop. So I think the whole focus thing is one of the problems, that it's gotten so wide and they're introducing new stuff without really kind of finishing everything that they already have, and also playing a bit of catch up with regards to performance, especially.
Yeah, I think from my point of view, I think one of the organic growth blockers or kind of slowers is now Dart in a way. People are maybe a bit skeptical on learning a new language, even though Dart is probably one of the fastest languages to pick up. And it's then once you get used to it, it's really convenient and nice to write. But I think because there's really not much. I mean, if you look at, like, for instance, I've shown like Stack Overflow questions from Dart relating and then questions from Flutter on the same graph, and those graphs follow each other exactly. So
yeah,
it's like Dart is basically the same thing as Flutter. So people are not picking up the language. So the only reason to pick it up is Flutter. So then that might be a bit of an issue for some people, even though I would argue that it's really not an issue. It's just a fun thing to learn.
And also maybe the fact that they are so heavily invested in Material UI widgets, that takes a lot of development time. And basically, then if you're really creating a complex app, you're not going to use it anyways. You're going to do your custom widgets anyway. So maybe some people think they're doing it in vain, and they need to rewrite them or redo them once in a while when the guidelines change and stuff like that. So
yeah, it could be.
Or there's a comment in the chat, actually. Someone says, I bit disagree on how fun Dart is, maybe after Java, but otherwise quickly it looks like quite verbose.
I think it's quite nice compared to writing, for instance, with TypeScript and React Native. I find it okay. It's not my favorite language, mind you, but it's less painful than most.
Yeah, it's an IDE language in a way, so it's meant to be used with an IDE.
Something that does your writing for you.
Yeah.